Two women who think they should have received bigger divorce settlements have taken their cases to the Supreme Court in a landmark hearing. They say their husbands deliberately kept quiet about how much cash and assets they actually had. The case could set a precedent for the future if people can prove they were intentionally misled by former partners. Our legal correspondent Clive Coleman is there. So how significant could this be?
Very in a word, Sophie. This goes to the heart of our divorce system. It's about honesty. It's about honesty when identifying your financial assets on divorce, and whether if you tell a deliberate lie, try and hide your assets or try and minimise them, the court order that approves your settlement can simply be set aside and the whole thing renegotiated again. Now, in one of these cases, a woman called Alison Sharland accepted a £10 million divorce settlement from her internet entrepreneur husband, Charles. Now, that may seem a huge amount of money, but it later transpired that he had misled the court in relation to the true value of his company and the fact that it was going to be floated on the stock market. She went to the Court of Appeal. The Court of Appeal said, yes, he did deliberately mislead the court, but it wasn't significant. It didn't affect the amount you were going to get. She has appealed to the Supreme Court, and today, in that case and another case that's joined with it, the Supreme Court has started to consider whether in effect we have a divorce system that tolerates some fraud, or whether any fraud, any lie at all, means that you can in effect rip up the court order and renegotiate your entire divorce financial settlement.
So, Clive, thank you. Planning